Set for another enthralling race here in the Kingdom of Bahrain. A Ferrari stronghold in years gone by, but will they be able to add to their record today? There's no shortage of passing opportunities around the 3.36 miles of the Bahrain International Circuit, with the best at Turn 1, of course, and then another soon into Turn 4. 15 corners here, 6 to the left and 9 to the right, and we could see one or two flat spots into the tight left-hander of Turn 10. Now, Anthony Davidson, I wonder, might we be in for some early pit stops today from the midfield teams, all trying to put some pressure on or disrupting things for the leaders up front?
If you're in the middle of the pack, you know, you got your own race to run, I don't think they're going to be thinking about causing trouble up front. However, closer to the head of the pack, don't be surprised to see some split strategies. If you're running second and third, for example, bringing one car in for an undercut while leaving the other one out there longer can put a lot of pressure on the leader and maybe force them into an error.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Joker lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Norris, Daniel Ricciardo, and Perez, Gasly, Hamilton, Leclerc, and Sebastian Vettel, Magnussen, Stroll, Alexander Albon, and Hubert, Ocon, De Vries, George Russell, and Nicholas Latifi, Kvyat, Grosjean, Correa. They've taken a grid penalty, and Antonio Giovinazzi.
Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. That's a decent start. Good job. A new fastest lap of the race. Overtake button more, it's time to utilize some of this energy. Some information on Hubert, they're retiring from the race. We're approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. We're leading our teammate by 20.6 seconds. push now. We're boxing this lap. Expect the grip levels to start falling away soon. Go now. Up to speed now. Let's get some heat into those tires. We're running an excess on fuel. Mix 3 is there if you need it. Mix 3. Is coming in for his stop. Okay, the gap behind is 15.4 seconds. let's use overtake and burn some of this energy. Okay, you're creating some breathing space between you and the car behind by a few seconds per lap. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap, final lap of the race. That's a race win. You've really been great today.
that's it for another spectacular Grand Prix here in Bahrain and a real champion's drive to take the win. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. This is their championship lead. Let's focus on the driver of the day, Anthony Davidson. Who do you pick?
Charles Leclerc showed exactly how to manage yourself out on the track today. He was almost flawless out there. Incredible stuff.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from Red Bull this time out, and they improve their position in the championship. After an event like that, who knows what...